That's it, guys. I didn't do much talking, but I just felt like this, that was a really nice piece of Georgetown. Just gonna leave as a preform. Some fingernails on it there. But she shrunk a little bit. Georgetown's like is really slick, but man, stuff's notorious for like these little fingernails. Probably don't see them on a lot of older artifacts, obviously, because they've probably been in the ground for 1,000 years or so. So it's actually some decent flaking on it. Needs a little bit more work on this one side, but. See if I get it. Got a hinge right here. It's not really as deep as it as you think it is, but I can come over from here and knock that out eventually. But all direct percussion with just a moose antler and a small disc hammer stone. Light, right? So it needs a little bit more work, but this Georgetown's really good stuff. I got it from Jim Conacher out at the Flint Ridge in Ohio, and the first piece I hit, I was like, wow, there's like no flaws in it. It's just smooth the whole way through. I could probably put something on this, I guess. The one guy on aerodynamics, Adam Blitzcrank, he uses like a beeswax to cover up these fingernail hinges. And I've never seen that before, and it worked really cool. But check the video out, guys. Primarily just use this billet, maybe a little bit of the bigger one. The initial bifacing, then just switch down to my regular, smaller billet, and the hammer stone, and the initial spalling was with this hammer stone here. Cool. I guess while I have a little bit of time yet, this will be a long video, but I wanted to show you. This is all the rock I got from out the Flint Ridge. Well, most of it. Let's see it all. So I got quite the selection of rock going on right now. There's another piece of that. Is it right there? Another piece of that killer Georgetown right there. I got a bunch of big Pedernales tabs. Oh, got some Keokuk over there laying. See it? And that's about it. But check the video out, guys. And yeah, later.